Hey guys, it's Mego here, and today I'm bringing all you beautiful Megas another brand new video on the channel, and today's video is going to be a little bit of a step back from all the Five Nights at Freddy's World teasers. We're going to take a little bit of a step back to Five Nights at Freddy's 4 and go over a very, very cool theory that I have found, and me and Zombie Wars SMT have actually been speculating a lot about the possible dream theory, or it was all in your mind theory. I guess you could say, as a lot of people were speculating that all the first three games actually were just a dream of the child that you play as in Five Nights at Freddy's 4, or like any other child, I guess you could say, because of the teaser message on scottgames.com that did say, what is seen in the shadows is often misinterpreted in the eyes of the child, or something like that. And there's also the toy Chica without the beak teaser, and the four games one story. So a lot of people are speculating that all of the games are actually just a dream, and that all of the games were just in the child's mind that you actually play as Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Me and Zombie were coming up with a theory about how we actually play as the girl that we see in the Five Nights at Freddy's 4 minigame with the toy animatronics, and the toy animatronics never actually existed in real life. It's all just her imagination. She saw some weird things, maybe about like Purple Man putting somebody into the Springlock suit so that she thinks of each other, he's stuffing people and killing people. Maybe she saw the boy that you play as in Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Maybe she saw that his head got crunched by Fredbear. That's why she has nightmares about Golden Freddy. I don't know, guys. We couldn't really like weave in. I think we pretty much got Five Nights at Freddy's 2 in the story with that interpretation, but we couldn't really weave in Five Nights at Freddy's 3. That was the hardest one for us to really weave in. So we never really came up with an entire theory, I guess you could say. But right now, I think somebody actually has. So I'm going to bring this up right now, guys. I'm going to bring up this new post. This person has got very, very close to uncovering a Five Nights at Freddy's like entire dream-like theory. This person's name is Cheeky Cha. So Cheeky Cha on Steam. I believe this person may have just unraveled the Five Nights at Freddy's mystery. I personally do not believe that it was all a dream. Maybe one of the games, maybe Five Nights at Freddy's 2 was all a dream. But I do not believe that every single game was all a dream, guys. I don't think Scott would do that to us, you know, because Scott wasn't even planning on having sequels when he made the first game. So I don't believe that Scott is actually going to make it that was all a dream. That would be very unsatisfying for me, to be honest, guys. I do believe that the first three games, or at least the first game and the third game, actually did take place at some point in time, or they are a different character entirely. I'm not sure. Maybe the third game is like the girl as she grows up. I really don't know. There's so much confusion about the Five Nights at Freddy's lore, guys. That's why we just want to theorize, and this theory right here is a very, very good theory, so I'm going to read it for you guys. It says, master list of why Five Nights at Freddy's 1 through 3 are FNAF 4 kids' comatose dream. So essentially, the Five Nights at Freddy's 4 minigames aren't just the only events that actually happened, but also explain every single detail about why the main child dreamed slash imagined everything that happened in Five Nights at Freddy's 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to scroll down a little bit to write to you now. Five Nights at Freddy's 1, why the animatronics hunt you down at night and kill you? There's a girl in FNAF 4 that teases you, saying that at night the animatronics come to life and make it so that you'll never be found again. Why Foxy is the one to have that you have to keep an eye out for, that can just come rushing towards you to jump scare you? Your brother often jump scared you with the Foxy mask on. Why there's a door to the left and right, or why there are doors to the left and right that you close to protect yourself? You had a door to your left and right in your actual room in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 that you would close to protect yourself. That's only in the actual game sections, and we do know in the mini games you only have one door. So this part is a little bit fishy, I guess you could say. There also are a lot of other things in this theory that don't make a lot of sense, so that's why I don't really think it is the comatose theory, but this is as close as we can get with an actual like comatose theory, that you're actually just dreaming the entire all four games. It says, why there's a fan and a phone. You had a toy fan and a toy phone in your room in FNAF 4, so you're gonna dream them being in all the other games, I guess you could say, that you play as. The missing children incident, reflect your feelings about your bullies on night 5 of FNAF 4, and maybe that you wish they were dead. So possibly, guys, on night 5 of FNAF 4, when you actually got hurt by the bullies, you wanted to cause revenge on those bullies. Those are the 5 missing children. Maybe they died because of you in your mind, because you want revenge on them. It's me, it says, that you're the one creating all this. Golden Freddy is able to teleport and such because he was your imaginary friend in the first place. It's especially dangerous slash mysterious because it was Golden Fredbear the Golden Fredbear animatronic that bit you in the head. And that would also be able to, another thing that he didn't miss in this, if you actually are dreaming up the Five Nights at Freddy's 1 minigame, the Five Nights at Freddy's 1 game, and you're actually the child that that was bit in the Bite of 87. Say the bite in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 is the Bite of 87, actually, and that we know that Fredbear caused the Bite of 87, the phone guy in the child's mind would be able to imagine It's amazing what the body can do without the frontal lobe, because the child is actually in a coma. He's dreaming the entire game. That would make a lot of sense, guys, because he actually is still alive. So he still survived the bite of 87. He knows that's the bite of 87, but he still survives. So he tells himself that it's amazing what the body can do without the frontal lobe. So even though he knows he's losing, he missed his frontal lobe, he can still dream all these amazing dreams. That's why he says it's amazing what the body can do without the frontal lobe. I don't know, guys. I think that does make a lot of sense. That's one thing that he didn't miss that I wanted to add on to that. Then we're going to go into Five Nights at Freddy's 2, where it does say the toy animatronics. I have always wondered why their official names were toy animatronics. It's because in Five Nights at Freddy's 4, you see a child playing with tiny toy figurines that are in the exact same pose as you see the Five Nights at Freddy's 2 bots in. Toy Chica's missing beak. She's seen without her beak because Toy Chica figurine seen in FNAF 4 had her beak off. In FNAF 4, there was a room in your house where Toy Foxy slash Mangle was all taken apart in pieces, probably by your brother. Balloon Boy, in Five Nights at Freddy's 4, we see the chubby kid in the street holding a balloon. Yeah, I have done a video on that as well. If you guys want to go check out that video, this is your representation of him. Shadow Bonnie and Purple Freddy. In Five Nights at Freddy's 4, when you see the silhouettes of Spring Bonnie and Fredbear from behind the show curtain, they appear purple from your viewpoint. Scott's site briefly had the message, "What is seen in the shadows is easily misunderstood in the mind of a child." This sighting would explain how Shadow Bonnie and Purple Freddy came to be in the child's mind. So essentially, guys, Shadow Bonnie and Purple Freddy never existed in real life, and we just saw the character who plays in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 only saw these animatronics, their silhouettes, from the show stage, so he thinks these guys are scary because he knows that that Fredbear actually bit off his head later on, so he thinks that these animatronics are going to be scary. That's why you just see them in Five Nights at Freddy's 2 as, like, hallucinations in Five Nights at Freddy's 2. The puppet. I believe he is meant to represent you. You're the one pulling the strings behind all these things. After all, I'm not sure about that, though. So essentially, I do believe that the puppet could possibly be... there has been some speculation that the puppet actually says at the end of FNAF 4, "I will put you back together." So possibly the puppet has some type of relationship to that in Five Nights at Freddy's 2. I don't know, though, guys. I really don't know. The puppet is a little bit of a mysterious topic, I guess you could say. So it says, "Purple guy being a killer. In a FNAF 4 minigame Easter egg, you briefly saw Purple Guy putting a guard into a Spring Bonnie suit. Purple Guy was just a regular employee doing his job. He was never a killer. But since you are a child that associates being stuffed into the suits or head getting bitten with being killed, you make the incorrect association that Purple Guy is some sort of killer. Phone Guy mentioning that Foxy is his favorite." I'm not sure about this one as well, but Phone Guy's voice may or may not represent the voice of your father, and this may represent you talking like your dad prefers your brother, the one who jump scare you with the Foxy mask over you. So that's why the Phone Guy would prefer Foxy. That does make a lot of sense as well. So the Bite of 87, the Foxy, all this Phone Guy stuff does make sense, guys. Why the events to the left and right that animatronics can come out of and into your office? You had two doors to your left and your right in the room in Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Why Foxy is the one you have to keep an eye out for that can just come rushing towards you to jump scare you? Again, see the FNAF 1 explanation, same thing for the Fan and Phone, Missing Children incident, and Golden Freddy again. Now we're getting into Five Nights at Freddy's 3. This is the point where I think that there are a lot of inconsistencies, I guess you could say, that don't really make sense. Five Nights at Freddy's 3 has always been a little bit of mysterious. It's always been like the odd game out, you know, it doesn't really relate to the other games all that much. But let's just read what he does have to say for Five Nights at Freddy's 3. I don't think this one's the best theory per se for Five Nights at Freddy's 3, but let's just read it anyway, guys. It does say, "Springtrap. In the Five Nights at Freddy's 4 minigame, a girl talks to you about her Spring Bonnie plushie and calls it a finger trap, talking about how her finger would get stuck in there." That still doesn't really make sense for why a spring trap would jump scare you and stuff like that, though. "A purple guy dying in a spring trap is a suitable death for him," I guess you could say, pun intended. "Again, you saw Purple Guy as a regular employee, not a killer, suiting up a guard in a Spring Bonnie suit, which was terrifying in your mind. How ironic for him to come to the same end. The bad ending. This happens if you don't forgive the child bullies that lead to your death. They continue to live on in your mind as murderous animatronics. The good end. You get what you never had on your actual birthday, a party. No bullies, cake, balloons, only happiness. You forgive the bullies that lead to your death. The balloons floating up represent your final passing on into the afterlife. Why Springtrap can get you from either the left or the right. Again, you had doors to your left and the right in Five Nights at Freddy's 4. And then Shadow Bonnie, Purple Freddy, Phone Fan. All this stuff is the same explanation as the other previous explanations that he has gone over. And it says there are real-life ties found in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 that explain every single thing that the child dreams of before he dies. And as we already know from the flowers, pills, IV drip in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 and the flatline during the cutscene after Night 6, it is heavily implied that you are almost dead in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 and then die. Yes, guys, I believe this does make a lot of sense. There are a lot of inconsistencies due to the Final Fantasy 3, though. Why isn't there a Phantom Bonnie? Why is there a Phantom Puppet? Other stuff like that, guys. There are a lot of inconsistencies with Five Nights at Freddy's 3 that don't really make sense in this theory. I do believe, though, Five Nights at Freddy's 2 is almost guaranteed to have all been just a dream. I don't think the toy animatronics actually ever existed. That's why in Five Nights at Freddy's 1, if it actually does take place in a real location, they wouldn't have any toy animatronics. They would go back to, like, the older versions of the animatronics, I guess you could say. There were never actually any real toy animatronics. They were just from Fredbear and Friends, and they were, like, actual toy figures. And the child actually is very scared of them. I really would not want this theory to actually be completely true, though. I do believe there actually are some animatronics that actually did try to kill the Night Guards. I don't know. It doesn't really make sense, guys, to be honest. But I kind of like that theory, that there actually were animatronics in real life. Because if there were actually no animatronics at all, and it was all just this child's imagination, that would just stink. You know, that would just absolutely stink. It would really make me sad that the Final Fantasy was all a dream and we just did nothing. I don't know, guys. Let me know what you guys do think down below in the comment section about this theory. Let me know if you guys did enjoy this theory and want to see more videos like this in the future. Slap that like button if you guys did enjoy today's video. Let's try to go for 100 likes on today's video. And let me know down below in the comment section, what is your theory? That'll be the question of the day for today's video. What is your theory about the entire dreamlike state? I'll be reading every single comment on today's video. Also, be sure to hit that little red button that says subscribe for all the latest and greatest Five Nights at Freddy's World, and I guess we can go back to 4 as well, content, and a couple of other horror games that I am starting up on my channel very, very soon. I'm going to be having a Soma Let's Play coming up tomorrow, so hope you guys are excited about that, and hope you guys have a nice, safe, wonderful day.